out, and we have Dr. Peter McPherson from the MeTech, and he will be talking about the ways to present your ideas, and yeah, ask as many as questions you want at the end of this presentation.
I just wonder, can you all hear me if I just talk normally? Okay, so my name is Peter McPherson, and I am the head of the architecture program at Unitech. So we have a School of Architecture, Landscape Architecture, and Interior Design up there. So I've been invited to talk to you all today about presentation. Now, I don't know what sort of backgrounds many of you have, but I obviously see a lot of high school students kind of coming through and applying for architecture, and I see a whole broad range of kind of skills and kind of interests and subjects that you study at high school. And so I thought I'd kind of start right at the beginning about something that we call kind of a language of architecture. Okay, a way that architects, the way we understand the drawings that we do and the way that we can actually put those drawings together in our heads to understand those drawings as a building, as a three-dimensional thing. So, hands up if many of you have kind of got an idea around things like orthographic projection. A few of you, plans, sections, elevations, those things mean anything to anybody? A few of you? Not all of you. Okay. So, as I thought, right, as architects, you know, what we do is we produce drawings, okay? Like, some might talk about creating space or, you know, building buildings, but architects don't usually do that, right? We draw things, and those drawings are an expression of our ideas, okay? They're a communication device. They're how we communicate what's in our head visually to other people to kind of build it, but also to others to understand it, okay, to understand what we're thinking, to understand what our expression is, okay? Something that your drawing should have is this idea of a sense of purpose, okay, and some intent. So don't just draw things for the sake of drawing things, okay? Draw things because there's a reason to draw it. Build a model, physical model. There's a reason to build it. Don't double up information. Okay? Everything you do, you're on a really limited time, right? So you don't want to waste time doing things that aren't important. Okay? If it's a drawing that's just a drawing but doesn't communicate or express your ideas, okay, with purpose and intent, then there's no point in doing that drawing. So what I say often is plan or design your presentation. Okay, before you start doing those drawings, plan out what it is that you might do. I'm going to come back sort of right at the beginning, okay? And I'd start here with our students in the School of Architecture because there is that wide variety. And so we have this thing called orthographic projection. And I'm going to start with kind of a simple shape, okay? And this is part of like a grammar we might have as architects, or a language that we have as architects, okay? So we have something three-dimensional, and that's what we're designing, okay? We're designing a three-dimensional thing. But it has a top view, okay, which we call the plan. It has a front view and a side view, and we might call those elevations in architecture, okay? But we can draw those with a relationship to one another, and you're all probably working digitally, right? Any of you going to be drawing by hand? Possibly not. But what I'll do is I'll kind of go through kind of where this comes from a bit, okay? Because it's important to understand the views and the images and the drawings that pop out of the computer. It's understanding where they come from in a more historical context. Because what it's about is that idea in your head and actually kind of committing that to paper, okay? So this is how orthographic projection looks, okay? So this is that three-dimensional object, that little L shape with the plan, the front view, and the side view all aligned to one another. Okay, so we can draw any one of those views, okay, and then start to put them together in our head. And what's important is this line here, okay? because this line turns the corner. So we can actually imagine if this was a box, right, a glass Perspex box that we look at, then we could draw this L on the front. We could fold that box over on this line. We could draw that shape on the top of our box. Then we could fold that line back around to the side. We could draw this rectangle on the side. Okay? And what we can then start to do is understand where in space these different points start to align with each other. Okay, so as a presentation or representation tool, this is kind of where we begin as architects. So when we lay out all of those drawings, if we start to put them together with this type of understanding, those viewing your work can start to put those drawings together in their head to gain an understanding of the three-dimensional thing. Okay. So this is again looking at that. This is that box, okay? The plan on top and the side views at the side. So this is that imaginary box that we unfold. Okay? Does that make sense? Some of you have seen that, some of you haven't seen that, and some of you have never seen something like that before. Yeah, a few of you. So this idea of language or grammar, I think, is really, really important. You know, here is us laying that out again without those lines, you know, running around, but we can understand that. Here's the front view on the front of the box. You can imagine an imaginary line running through here, that box folding over and seeing it from the top. We can imagine that imaginary line on the side folding over and seeing this on the side. And so what's interesting about this is we don't have all three of those views. We can't actually put together what the object is, okay? We just have these two. We don't know if this is, we could draw this as a square, right, or a rectangular thing. But when we add the top view, we understand that this is actually a circular object. Okay, so we need to put all of those drawings together to actually understand the full kind of picture of that shape, okay, that we're designing. And if we miss one, we can interpret the drawings in different ways. They're not kind of clearly communicating with intent. So another important couple of things, really, is always to label your drawings. Okay? A little label of what this is. You know, maybe it's the elevation to the north. Okay, and I've had kind of presentations around environment today, and you might be thinking on the northern elevation, you know, as kind of a designer, I might be expecting to see particular articulation of that facade, okay? It'd be quite different to what I see on the south, and probably a little bit different to what I see on the east and the west of your building, okay? But if you label them, then I don't need to do any thinking. I can figure it out and very quickly understand kind of what you're showing me. And scale, okay? We draw at scale as architects. Okay, we can't draw our buildings at 1:1. Okay? Why not?
Too big,
that's right. So we have to draw at a scale. So we have the thing called architectural scales, and they might be 1:50, 1:100, 1:200, kind of common scales that we understand the size of things. We draw on those scales, we understand how big a door is, how high a ceiling is, how big a person might be within those spaces. Okay, so labels, scale, and another thing, you know, another label that's really important is where is north. So you might have learned about where the sun rises, where the sun sets, how the sun enters your building, where you might start to orientate your solar panels to kind of receive kind of electricity and power for your buildings. If you don't show us on your plan, on your drawings, where north is, then people can't actually understand how well your buildings actually perform. So the way you communicate your drawings without words is really important. There's a few, you know, these are very simple things. They're not complex ideas. They're very refined as ideas, and they're very kind of universal. You can look at these drawings in any language and understand what they are and where they're from. Okay. This idea that the plan's sitting above your main view is kind of a clear one, so you can make those direct relationships between those two drawings. And that things that sit at the same level on the ground, you know, they're not kind of sitting one up a little bit higher than the other one, so you can make those connections across the drawings kind of along the base there. Okay. This one isn't a little bit higher, this one isn't floating over here somewhere. There is that direct relationship between those drawings, okay? So you can understand how to put it together again. So what might that start to look like in a building? Okay. So if we think of a little house like this, there are going to be some key drawings we pull off of that, okay, that we want to communicate about that. So we'll have some three-dimensional drawings, we'll have some perspectives, you know, that type of thing probably. But we'll also have some drawings which talk about the plan, perhaps a section, perhaps elevations of that building. All right. We might even have a site plan with a roof plan so we can understand what's going on with the roof of your buildings. Particularly if you're starting to add, you know, skylights, if you're adding photovoltaics, if you're planning to do roof gardens, all sorts of different things happening. So spend a little bit of time talking about this, okay? Because I think these are really crucial concepts to kind of present architecture with. So the first one is your plan, okay? The plan of the building is like taking an imaginary cut through your building, you know, anywhere from maybe 900 millimetres up to maybe 1500 millimetres. Okay, and what you're cutting through is you're cutting through the wall, you're cutting through doors, you're cutting through windows, okay, so that when you view that drawing, you can see where you can move, where you can't move, where light can come in, where light doesn't come in, okay. And you can see that very clearly in that drawing. Does that make sense? This idea of a cut at one height that you can start to see this information on. Okay? About doors, windows, walls. You can understand walls have thickness, right? This thing here, it's got thickness. And we know that light won't come through that. We know we can enter through the door. Okay? We know we can't move through here, but we know that light comes through here through the windows. And we're talking about things like environmental design, you know, importantly, we need to know where that light comes from and what I'm looking at. So the plan will be a fundamental drawing for your room. So you're organising the space in your building, putting the rooms next to each other, starting to look at the communication of those spaces, the circulation, how your building sits on the site. You'll be kind of doing a lot of that work referring to that plan drawing.